Students at Fielding High School are up in arms about tough new rules governing their hair, which they say could see them suspended for wearing a bit of hairspray. The school has cracked down on hair product, colour and length in a blitz which has seen half the fifth form pulled up for unacceptable hair. One student says her rights to freedom of expression and education are being affected, and she's thinking of taking the matter further. Corinne Ambler visited Fielding High.
They go to Fielding High School and all have been in trouble for their hair, but none as much as 15-year-old Emma Curtin.
Are you going to wear any hair product today?
Yeah, just a little bit of hairspray. It just keeps it up a bit at the back.
Already this term, Emma's been sent home once and pulled out of class four times, her hair deemed an extreme of fashion. She was among half the fifth form held back at a recent uniform check.
Senior member of staff said to me that my fringe is too long, that I can't see out of it, when I can see perfectly fine, that I had product in the back so I had to wash it out, and that my hair wasn't a natural colour so I had to dye it. And apparently it's an extreme of fashion.
Personally, I think it's a bit over the top. There seems to be no room in that school for individuality or freedom of expression. I mean, this is 2008. They should be allowed some sort of expression of personality.
Emma's not the only one upset at the tough new rules. Sam McGregor was recently off school for 3 days because his fringe was too long.
We were inspected as we left the hall. They didn't like what they saw. We were told to sit down, and they recorded our names and we had to fix it, and there were just a lot of people. Girls were crying in the queue because they were scared to go in and things like that. It's just become very vicious about it.
Some of the kids think it's a bit over the top, that you know they're getting sent home for a bit of gel.
Well, basically they're in our rules and we have to hold the line, I suppose. No point having the rules if you're not holding the line, I make no excuse for holding the line.
So have any kids been suspended or expelled for having, you know, too much hair product in?
One boy, we had an issue with gel, one boy this year. We stood him down for 2 days, met with his mother, and he's back in school now wearing no gel.
In a quick trawl of the playground, we found plenty of examples of those flouting the rules.
Oh, yeah, like every day, really. Just walking around school, just get told off for my hair.
I got told either accept the rules or find another school. I mean, it's only here. I don't see why they're doing this.
Keep getting in trouble for putting wax in my hair, because you got to look good for school.
Is that why you do it, so you look good?
There's girls everywhere. So yeah.
But you're very unpopular over this.
Oh, well, that goes with the territory, I suppose. Emma signed the regulations when she joined the school to say she's divided by our school rules, so really, you know, if she's unhappy and her parents are unhappy with our rules and regulations, you've got two choices. Get on the board and change some things, or two, find another school.
But he admits more rules have been added since Emma started, such as no hair product. And ironically, the inside page of the school prospectus shows a boy with what looks suspiciously like product in his hair.
Some people might say that you're at school to learn, not to, you know, be in a fashion parade.
Exactly. They need to focus more on our learning, not on our appearances. Because they focus more on our appearances than what we're learning and how we're doing in school.
Emma and Sam want to leave Fielding High, but all the other schools in the area are full. She and others have vented their feelings on Bebo sites, attracting support from both students and parents.
Have you seen some of the names they're calling you?
No, I haven't. I haven't. Wouldn't surprise me what they call me. Probably goose-stepping Hitlers, am I?
Not quite.
Oh, I think she's very brave for standing up for what she believes in, and I'm quite proud of her for taking it to the extent she is.
So how did you get her to cut her hair in the end?
just spoke to her and said to her that in this instance I think she needed to give in some ground, even though she wanted to fight for it all the way, because I knew in past incidences with this principal, he just puts his foot in and expels people.
She's an intelligent kitty, and like some youngsters, you know, they feel as though they're getting a rough deal from time to time, but that's not new. It was the same in my day. I can remember having, you know, challenging the school with the length of my sideboards back in 1968. Nothing's changed, has it?
Oh, really? And did you have to chop them off?
Yes, I did.
It's not only us, it's the future generations. We just want to be our own individuals and have our own sense of style and own individuality, and we're being denied that.
So, should we care about hair? With me now, the principal of Fraser High School, Martin Elliott from Hamilton, and the Children's Commissioner, Cindy Kiro. Cindy Kiro, I mean, what's so wrong with kids having to learn to follow some rules?
Well, I think it's perfectly reasonable that schools set bylaws and that kids have to follow some rules. And there's always, in situations like this, I think, a negotiation. But, you know, the question is, are these rules absolutely crucial? And in particular, are they important for the safety or the learning of these children? I mean, you know, hair product, frankly, I can't think of a young man that I know that doesn't go without hair product. I mean, you have to make sure that the rules are actually sensible rules to apply them. But there has to be a bit of give and take, and I've had lots of cases, individual cases, come to my office, for example, where there's been issues about hair, length of hair, type of hair, and we've been able to negotiate some sort of solution. I think there has to be a bit of give and take in this situation. I think Emma's dad made the comment that there needs to be a little bit of give and take, and that she's cut her hair, so she's obviously prepared to go some way. I think the school maybe needs to look at what's important and focus on that.
Is it a human rights issue?
I think probably it's on the borderline. I'm not sure that it is, actually. But certainly in the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child, under Article 12, which is the right to expression, and Article 28, the right to education, it talks about some things that I heard Emma talking about. So they're certainly there. But I think it's a bit borderline as to whether or not it's a breach of human rights.
Mark, now I see you were starting to grin when the human rights issue came up there.
Very much so, Mark. Yes, I did. Yes, I've listened to this conversation, and good evening, Cindy. Listen, I think what we all have to remember is schools are learning places and preparing young people for the world of work. And having kids ready for what we call work ready is something that's very, very important in this modern age. And employers tell us that many young people who leave schools, while they might be academically able and skilled, they lack the self-discipline and rigour to actually work in the workplace. Now, I put it to you, Mark, that in many of our workplaces that our kids go to work after school and weekend, there is a code of appearance and behaviour that people expect. If they work in a supermarket, if they work in the mobile petrol station or Kentucky Fried Chicken or wherever, the bosses will say, we expect you to dress accordingly.
So is it just now, a matter then of making rules just to show that we're in charge, though?
No, I don't think it is. Not at all. I certainly don't do that. And I know the principal of Fielding fairly well, and I know he doesn't do that either. But what we're talking about is having rules and regulations, bylaws, in fact, which in fact make consistency within your school. And secondly, we're talking about work ready for employment.
Cindy Kiro, the issue of suspending pupils who don't follow the rules on grooming, is that an appropriate thing to do? Should you be, you know, denied an education because you don't cut your hair?
I think the simple answer is no. I mean, I think it's a rather extreme position to take. And I accept that there have to be rules. I said that in my opening statement. I absolutely accept that. And the kids that I've seen complaining in this instance follow the rules. I mean, they're all wearing uniforms. The only issue that I can see is that there's an issue around hair, for example, with Emma. Frankly, when I saw Emma's haircut, it looked better than most women's hair that I see in Wellington or Lambton Quay on a windy day. I mean, it looked pretty reasonable to me. The rules have to be reasonable, and that's what we need to be enforcing. They're there to get an education. Yes, they have to follow the rules. Schools have the right to make bylaws, but those bylaws have to be reasonable. The focus should be on the right things, not on ridiculous things.
I mean, Martin, now, you take a pretty tough stand in your school. It's, you know, it's my way or the highway.
No, not necessarily my way or the byway. It's the rules that have been set by the Board of Trustees of our school, which are the parents of the school. And in Fielding High School, it's the same thing. The bylaws are actually set by the parents. Now, if a parent doesn't like the bylaws that have been set up by the parents of that school, then perhaps they should, as I was said before, get on the board and change the rules, or send your child to a school where they've got mediocre rules. Very simple.
Martin Elliott, Cindy Kiro, thanks both for joining us tonight. I mean, I'm sure this is an issue which will carry on after the next generation as well.